Hey guys, so for number 33, we're going to simplify the complex fraction. A complex fraction just means a fraction within a fraction. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to find our LCD. So the LCD is going to be a term that we're going to distribute into our numerator and denominator that's going to get rid of the fraction within the fraction. So in order to find the LCD, we first need to take into account all of the factors inside of the denominators. In this case, our denominators are x, 4, and 12, and technically 1 because this 9 has a denominator of 1. So we're only looking at the factors of the denominators. So this x in its most factored form is just x. The 4 in its most factored form is 2 to the power of 2. And this 12 in its most factored form is 3 times 2 to the power of 2. And then this 1 is just 1. This 1 doesn't really matter, but I'll leave it there just for clarification. The next step in finding the LCD is to not repeat any of the factors. But if they do repeat, then you're going to take the factor that's repeated with the highest degree. So, for example, here we have x squared and x squared. Since they're both the same degree, we're just going to go ahead and cancel out one of them. So, the factors that we're going to take into account in our LCD are going to be x, 2 to the power of 2, 3, and 1. And when I combine all of those together, that's going to give me 12x. So, my LCD is 12x. So I'm going to multiply 12x into the numerator and the denominator. Be careful with this part right here. Technically, you are distributing 12x over 1 into the numerator and then 12x over 1 into the denominator. So 12x over 1 times 9 over 1 is going to give us 108x. 12x over 1 times 3 over x is going to give us 36x over x. Now in the denominator, 12x over 1 times x over 4 is going to give us 12x squared over 4. And now 12x over 1 times 1 over 12 is going to give us 12x over 12. Now let's go ahead and simplify this as much as we can. And if we did the LCD correctly, we shouldn't have any fractions within fractions. So it looks like here we can cancel out the x and the x. Here we can cancel out a term of 4. So 12 divided by 4 is 3, and 4 divided by 4 is 1. And then here we can cancel out the 12 and the 12. So that leaves us with 108x plus 36 over 3x squared plus x. Now we're going to take out the GCF of the numerator and then the GCF of the denominator and see if anything cancels out. The GCF in my numerator is 36, and that leaves me with 3x plus 1. And now my GCF in my denominator is x, and that leaves me with also 3x plus 1. So it looks like now I can cancel out the terms of 3x plus 1 in the numerator and 3x plus 1 in the denominator, leaving me with my final answer of 36 over x.